What is going on, everybody? My name is Chris. That's Mike. Welcome
that's
back
right.
to Third Person.
Yes.
That was an awkward intro, but that's fine. Woo Assassins, Mikey. We're back. We're episode six. It's Goo Assassins, which is interesting. Goo being what, the opposite of Woo, I believe. And the ability to take the Woo away, which is the theme for this episode. I got some things to say about this episode. Last episode, I went on a little bit of a rant as to, you know, people not liking the show and whatnot. And I was like, you know what? You should like it because of these things. So, you know, again, this episode is really cool. We got a bunch of stuff in this episode. You know, one, of course, being the brutal ass fight between Zan and Jenny, which I was like, when are we going to see this fight? And then all of a sudden we saw the fight. And I was like,
and then we see the fight. And unfortunately, Jenny got
her ass whooped, but that's okay. We'll get back to that.
Ass kicking of a lifetime.
Here's the thing. So it's decided that, you know, look, Six cares for Kai. Kai does care for Six. And he's like, they come to this decision that they're going to take the power away. As opposed
Instead
to
of killing him.
Killing each other. Because he shows Kai the scroll, and he's like, we're destined to kill each other. But, you know, you have these two people who, you know, essentially they're family, I guess, you know.
Well, he says it in this episode.
Well, he calls him his son.
Kai says his dad. He's like, dad.
Right, so, they don't want to kill each other, so they decide, okay, we'll get rid of this, and then we'll go after the rest. I'll help you go after the rest of the Woo.
Yeah, so, the big part, even before that, is will it even work? So
that's
why
they don't know if it's going to work. Right.
Ying Ying says it's never worked before, but she kind of gives him this recipe, which the beginning of the episode starts with.
Mm-hmm.
It's very interesting how it was cool how they did that. They each had to cut their blood
because
touched the fire woo.
By a woo. They were touched by a woo, which, you know,
so,
sounds creepy, but.
Yeah,
I guess it is.
So it's cool. You're pinning a frog up against a scorpion and a
snake and
and all this kind of stuff. So
spider. Yeah,
at the end,
cool.
We get the goo, which is cool. But I mean, as these episodes progressed, we've seen and questioned Six a lot about where his intentions are. And I even thought that, you know, in one of the previous episodes, he didn't care for Kai at all. So we obviously see that for this guy to be willing to give up his power for Kai and. I mean, he put all his cards out on the table, essentially Six. So I thought that was interesting for me to see during this episode. And after being even fed the goo, I thought it was kind of cool that remember we were like with the veins started blackening and stuff. I thought that was
it's almost like Exorcist, right?
Yeah,
it's like an exorcism.
Yeah, it's pulling.
It's an exorcism. But he was like, "Hey, come here," and he grabbed Tommy and stuff. And it's like, yeah, it was. It was pretty good. Look, I mentioned this before, last episode and stuff, but like the actors in this show are fantastic. I love every single actor in this show. So whether you don't like the story or not, these actors are carrying this story and carrying these characters. Absolutely. And, you know, speaking about that, the show to me is like, I'm just seeing the friendship and the bond and like the family aspect of it. Like I'm really enjoying. I didn't anticipate it going in this direction, but I'm absolutely loving the whole family and friendship and bonding aspect of this show. So you have these four friends, dude. It's almost like an '80s buddy show, buddy movie, like almost
I keep going. I'm sorry.
It reminds me of Big Trouble in Little China. Doesn't it?
Yeah, okay.
It reminds me of like Big Trouble in Little China, where you have all these people coming together.
Yeah.
To defeat this mystical thing.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And one's got the mystical power and, you know, it's like, that's one of my favorite movies. And
Can we bring back the old Kim Cattrall from that era?
I know. Yeah. Let's
oh my
bring
God,
back.
I love
yeah.
Her. I
the
love
green
her.
Eyed, right? The anyone
yeah.
with green eyes, right?
Yeah.
That was the whole thing.
She was, it's funny because to go off topic a second.
Yeah.
So, for you guys out there, no one really knows, what I do for a living, but I work in a hospital. I work in a radiology department. And, a few years back, I actually, brought, who's the actor who plays Mahoney? What's his name? I'm sorry. Steve Guttenberg came in with his dad. So I'm bullshitting with Steve Guttenberg, and he had all these kind of like outlines plotted to all the floors and stuff. Not like he's a dick, but like just to say don't bother him technically.
Yeah.
So it's funny because he was in, Kim Cattrall was in Police Academy, and she was just my, you know, she's insane. So it was a moment where I did want to say to Steve Guttenberg, how lucky were you to make out and to film Police Academy with Kim Cattrall. So that was my Steve Guttenberg story about Kim Cattrall, really quick to go off topic.
No, that's fine.
But I didn't do it because I respected the guy's wishes of not bothering him about his acting roles. Super off topic, but it was just funny story.
That's awesome. Hey, man, that's a
so whatever, yeah, right? No, but one part of what you were saying about the group and how the friendships are there. It was kind of cool, the scene with Tommy and Lucian about. Listen, dude, I mean, you want to hang out? You know, it's like for the longest time, Lucien blamed Tommy. And I guess
their relationship. It's Lucien, I think.
Lucien?
Not to correct it, but I think it's Lucien. Well, and it's Wu.
Okay, sorry, Louis Tan.
Yeah.
I mean, I think they had it listed as Lou anyway. But anyway, so.
No, but you know what, though? Real quick, they call him Lucien. And like, that's how they say his name.
Yeah.
And we call him Lou. Right, but yeah, everyone else calls him Lou, but they also, but lately in these past episodes, they call him Lou.
Maybe because their Lucien. Bond is.
And you know what I do? Yeah. I leave on the I'm leaving on. I've been leaving on the subtitles.
Mm.
You know, because sometimes you know if they talk fast or whatever, like you
want. There are some.
You want to make sure, you know.
Yeah, yeah, no. So I mean, listen, it was cool. That was a cool scene because it's almost like. Lucien saying, dude, you know, it's my bad. We all blamed you. You were, you know, for the fire and all this kind of stuff when obviously it wasn't Tommy's fault. So to see that kind of bond kind of maybe start again was cool. I mean, just to see all of them together these past couple episodes, because that, you know, before these last two, everybody was here and there. It wasn't really everybody together.
Well,
all
that's
the
what
time,
I'm saying. So. That's what makes it fun. It's these are very well-built characters. They're very well.
Yeah.
They're well created and they're being fleshed out very, very nicely. And I enjoy it. I enjoy them very much. So it was really cool. So staying on the topic of Tommy, he finds these drugs. He talks to Kai and he's like, listen, I want you to help me out here.
Yeah.
I want you to basically beat up this girl's boyfriend. Right. He's like, I want you to beat up this girl's boyfriend. I met this girl. And, you know, it shows a scene back
in potentially even kill him
in rehab. Well, basically. Yeah. He wanted this guy out of the picture like, so he could step in and be like, hey, but that's the thing though. That's how Tommy thinks.
Man. Yeah. That's what I
good
like.
Intentions, but he's like, but he would kill some girl's boyfriend just so he
after
could look
just meeting her after.
Right. So he could look good to her. You know what I mean? Like that's just that's the character, but that's fine.
Yeah.
That's a junkie. Yeah. What do you want? But yeah. I thought it was hilarious. When he takes the gun back out, which I knew it would be gone when she's like, oh, take this gun. I'm like, they ain't going to be there. Yeah. Right. He fucking snaked it. He goes in and it's funny because I didn't understand what's happening at first. Now, I was like, wait, what's going on? He fumbles the gun. It goes off. And I didn't realize that was the guy. Like, I didn't put two and two together.
Yeah.
That was the guy, her boyfriend. And I was like, oh, but what I thought was hilarious after the whole thing ends and he bails out of the car. He's like, I'm gonna charge you with that. And he's like, fuck you. He just that was fucking great, man.
Yeah, great. I mean, listen, I put that at the bottom of my notes because I wanted to talk about it. That was like the worst because Tommy has kind of he says how he threw the drugs away at the AA meeting or whatever, and he's talking how. So you want? I mean, listen, you enjoy the Jenny Tommy stuff. I enjoy that also. So for me, I don't like, you know, for someone to be able to beat. That addiction is really cool, and for him to, you know, say that he hasn't used in a few days and all this kind of stuff, and he throws the drugs away, and then this pretty girl says this story about how she's being abused, and in one day meeting her, and then essentially willing to kill her boyfriend, you know, it kind of.
That's an addict, though, dude. That's that works perfect for the character.
But
that's what he does, man. That's
He's supposedly not.
He's impulsive,
using
dude.
Then.
He's impulsive. That's what happens.
I don't know. I just didn't like that, man.
Well, yeah, not liking it is one thing, but you know, again, that's That's what a junkie is.
I just didn't think it. Yeah, I just didn't think it made. There's this big thing going on right now in his life to where they just put their blood on these toads and shit, and it's making a goo potion and all this kind of stuff. So, you know, they killed these Russians in the previous episode and all this kind of stuff, and he's just worried about getting scorned with his chick or something. I don't know. I just thought it was a little weird. And really, the second question is, did he take the gun or did he accidentally
leave it?
So maybe that'll listen. If the guy's an Uber driver, like the chick said in the AA meeting, he should know who he's picking up.
Right.
So that could be an issue for Tommy down the road. So
we'll see what happens with that. So lastly, they do get the woo out of out of six, which is interesting because this is episode six and it's about six, right? So I don't know if you realize that, but yeah. So they get it out, and it's another piece of the shell.
Yeah.
And you know what it is? You know what I just realized?
Yeah.
Before I continue with that thought. Yeah, he looks at it and I remember. He looks at it, he says, "Oh, it doesn't say I have to kill him or something." He's like, "Oh, there's something here." And that's when Ying Ying was like, "Well, no, that doesn't work though." And that's when that whole thing. Okay, I was just remembering that. Okay. sorry. But anyway, so they get it out and he puts it in, you know, a takeout box, and they're like, "Really?" And he's like, "Well, yeah, you know, whatever."
Yeah.
Whatever, assholes.
Yeah.
He gives it to CG.
Yeah, because now we have a beaten down Six that's very weak.
Sick, and he's like, yeah.
And Kai and Six are now going to go after the Earth Wu. So I'm interesting because they know the coordinates of where the Earth Wu is. So, giving the takeout box and the monk piece to CG is going to, by all tellings of what happened in the end.
He's like, "Don't look at it." She's like, "I'm not."
Yeah, it's gonna be an issue for CG having such a valuable piece, especially since Zan knows that she has it, and Zan visits McCullough at the end,
right?
And she's going all, you know, rogue.
Oh, she's pissed. Oh, that was the other thing too. We got a quick scene with Zan and Jenny, which I thought was really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and she's like, and they're trying to measure each other's dicks is basically what happens. She's like, "Oh, you don't know what." She's like, "I came from nothing and sixth grade, you know, took me up and trained me and this and that and whatever." And she's like, you, that's better that you had nothing. I had parents that fucking gave me everything. And then
and it's hard to be perfect.
And it's hard to be perfect. Yeah. And it's like, both of you shut up. You know what I mean? It's like, stop trying to fucking measure dicks. Like, it's not about that. Yeah. But the fight was fucking brutal.
Yeah, no, it was.
Zan decimated her, but she kept getting up. That's one thing Jenny doesn't do is quit.
No, hell
no. You know, she kept getting up. She kept getting up. But,
and then Zan a day later, they're in the same room together.
Well, that's what that's what I like. I like that shit because you can't help that shit.
Yeah.
You can't help that shit. You know, they fought once, you know, under certain circumstances. This second set of circumstances was a controlled environment, where that's what they were there to do. And then it was a transaction. It was done. And then now they're, you know, now they're talking and stuff. And yeah, I liked it. The only thing, so one issue I have with where the story's going at this point is I guess Six isn't really going to help. I guess Kai's really is going to just do everything on his own anyway, because what's Six going to do? He's sick. You know what I mean?
No, well, he's only,
he knows where it is.
Power. But he can still fight. He's not going to have the. They're going to go together and do it. That's what they say.
Well, that's the thing. But now you're talking about a mortal and the Wu assassin against, you know, another.
Yeah,
you know,
I mean, he can still fight. You know, at what CG did.
I'm a little concerned. I'm just a little concerned.
CG protected Kai against potentially the death blow from Six when they fought in the casino. So he can still help.
I'm just concerned to see where it goes and what happens, you know.
Yeah,
because I like Six. I actually like Six. I do.
You've grown to really like him as a character because you know what his intention is.
And yeah,
you know,
I think I always did because he wasn't always. He was a prick, but he wasn't. But there was that underlying since day one. There was that underlying. Yeah, well, you're my son. I did this for you, and this is for you, and.
Yeah.
You know, and like, I don't know, I you know, maybe it's just also because I love the actor. I think he's fucking dope. I love everything he's been in and stuff. And it's just, you know, he was in, again, I've said it again, he's in Altered Carbon, and he plays OG Kovach. And oh my god, it's such a good show. Go watch it. It's also on It's also on Netflix. Go watch it. It's such an amazing show. I'm in the middle of the books too. There's three books for this first, for this particular character. So anyway, go watch it. All right. So yeah, Zan's an asshole. She says I want power. Yeah. Yeah. What an asshole. So we're going to see where that heads up. They're going after the Earth Woo. I want to see what's going that. I do know that Kevin Durant is playing the Earth Woo. Kevin Durant is an actor from fucking everything. That guy's awesome. I'm so happy. Again, I love this cast. I just love the cast that they got for this show. It's so good. So he's in that. He'll be in the next episode when we see the Earth Woo.
And, all right.
Yeah, so that's that. Mikey, take us home.
Check us out at Third Person on all the social medias. Write in the comment section below. Let us know what you think of the Woo Assassins, episode 6, the Goo Assassins. Really cool stuff. It's a really fun show. So let us know. We like to hear from you guys. ThirdPersonPod.com. You can type in the Google search. Right to our YouTube channel. Over the place, Third Person, on all the social media outlets. We have some cool stuff on there. We're doing the Terror. We had some Nosferatu stuff. So if you weren't watching Nosferatu, you can watch it. It was only 10 episodes for this first season. It was really good. We had an interview with John Bruno, who is like the special effects legend, where we talk about Nosferatu, and he obviously worked on the show. And for you a little bit older fans and viewers of Third Person, if you grew up in the 80s like Chris and I did, John also won an Oscar for The Abyss, and he's worked on Ghostbusters and
Poltergeist
and Avatar and Titanic and all these classic movies, True Lies. Shit, if you don't know any of those movies that we mentioned, you've never watched.
You know them. Go watch it.
Your life. So check those out. It's a really, really awesome interview. It's a two-parter. So check those out, because John just speaks and you just listen. That's all that.
Yeah, it's good.
That is to it. So we're all over the place. Thank you guys so much for the support. We'll see you next time.
See you next time. Bye.
Peace.